Welcome to Supply Chain 600 Seconds. Today I have with me Mikael Törnqvist from Aditro Logistics, who is Director Corporate Development. Can you please introduce yourself and tell us a bit about your company?
Yes, I can. And thank you, Stefan, and thank you for having me on this I don't know if you could call it a podcast or a video cast or something, but something like that. I'm Mikael Törnqvist. I'm the Director of Corporate Development, which means that I'm Head of Strategy at Aditro Logistics. I've been with the company around 6 years and had pretty much the same position ever since. I'm a member of the top management team of Aditro. Aditro Logistics, we are at the core a 3PL provider. So that's the main source of business. And I would say that we are the third largest in Sweden. We're present in Stockholm, Borås, and Jönköping, and I also have a warehouse in Norway. And since a year ago, rather precisely, we're owned by Posti Group. So we have a new ownership, which...
The Finnish postal organization.
So. Yes, exactly. So we're their second step into Sweden, and hopefully a very successful one.
I know that you are developing a lot right now and fueled by the Posti, of course, and the muscles that they have. Can you tell us something about the technical advancements? And I know that you also do some investing in like being a thought leader and really being on the forefront of the development.
Yes, that was pretty much a reason why Posti at first were interested in us. We have always tried to have a logtech mindset, to try to be innovative and think in new ways and try to find new solutions, because we have seen that logistics is now a strategic agenda on pretty much all companies. So we need to be on the same level as the ones in the corporates that we serve. Posti bought us, they decided that we should even accelerate this project even further. So we have we've started a logtech hub, which is it's a somewhat separate hub that will try to evolve and develop new technologies that can help us create a competitive advantage for our customers, because that is the most important thing we can do, because our business is more a derivative of the success of our customers. So if we can help them succeed, we will succeed. It's simple as that. So that's where we invest the most currently.
What are then the most important challenges that you have to cope with logistics business right now?
Well, the boom of e-commerce has redefined the way we think of logistics. So not only the challenges that comes with e-commerce, but it also set some challenges when it comes to other customer segments. Everyone needs to rethink and restructure their logistics to have the end customer in mind. E-commerce have learned end consumers how they can experience logistics. So when they order at the B2B, from a B2B point of view, they still expect a good service. And so it can take a week to get the products. And we can see the trend that the orders become smaller and smaller and more. So even B2B is turning into B2C like flows, and it really changes how we need to work with it, to have it efficient as previously, to have it sustainable, which is a very big topic right now. And so I would say that's the major trend that changes how we need to produce in our warehouses.
Mm. What do you see in the future? Because now there's a lot about speed and also delivery service to an extent. But how will this change in the future? Do you see any trends there?
Yes, of course. There is a lot of trends. I somewhat see and somewhat hope that sustainability will be a more predominant issue, where you actually can say that, yeah, right now we serve this region on Thursday, because that way we will have efficient freights and less emissions. So I would say that speed has what been the top priority, and it needs to be a level of service, sustainability, and more of a whole package in the future. And I will also say that flexibility is a very important issue. So if you order, you want to have it the day they say you order it, you will have it. So if they say this will come in a day, it will come in a day. If they say it will come in 2 days, it must come in 2 days. And when you have ordered, you will be able to change. So if you want it at home to a postal box, to a pickup point, you will be able to change that during the time of delivery. And that's something that creates challenges and where we hope to find some good solutions for it.
Okay, exciting, interesting. Let's talk a bit about automation, which is a big thing right now for all 3PLs, and not just automation within the warehouses. We're going to talk about the warehouse automation, but automating processes in general is a big issue. You have decided to invest in a automated warehouse. I think it's an AutoStore, isn't it? I know it's an AutoStore from Element Logic. Can you tell us about the basis for the decision to automate?
Yes, we have had a ongoing and quite in-depth analysis of the automation market for, I think we started 2017, and we started off by inviting pretty much all the big suppliers there is to our office at the same day. So all of them came, so it was a bit of a industrial meeting as well. But then we had one-to-one interviews, and we explained to them what we wanted, they explained what they could help us with. And from that point, we have developed a strategy when it comes to this. And so we've made other investments into automations, but now the big one is our upcoming one with an AutoStore from Element Logic. And the reason why we landed into an AutoStore is it's several, but most and foremost, it's very much suitable for our point of our business, since it's contract logistics. We need to be able to view it as the same way we view a warehouse, to have a longer commitment, longer time, but to have a possibility to change customers in them, to have several customers in them. And that's where we see that an AutoStore is the best solution, because it's actually very standardized, which is a very good thing for our business. And the standardizations goes through everything we do. We need to be able to extract all the possible synergies of having several customers at the site, and an AutoStore enables that. So that's the main reason. But otherwise, it's efficient enough. It's not the quickest automation on the market, but it's quick enough, and the threshold is how quick a picker can pick the goods rather than the machine, which makes it efficient enough. It's increases the site utilization, and it's very reliable, which is the main a very important part, because if it goes down, you will have some very tough tough problems, and that we've seen in other installations. So that's why AutoStore is a very good solution for us.
And your customer base, a lot of them within retail, of course, likes AutoStore as well. It's kind of a trendy way to go, you know?
Yes, so, it really much is. And we've seen it in many RFQs that they actually more or less demand an AutoStore. And it's not always the best solution for them, but it's a very, very strong brand right now. So yeah, it's more or less top of mind, but for a reason, I would say.
Yeah. So now you have decided to invest in it, and you will go live in a year or something like that with together with the Servera, I think.
Yes, that's correct.
What do you hope? What are your hopes to achieve with this investment, broadly speaking?
We hope to help Servera with their continuous development, so they can reach their goals. And I think that this is a must for us to do that together, because they have, as you might know, had a tremendous development during the last years. And I think they their e-commerce went up 400% last year or something. So it's been a very strong development.
And shift from the stores to the e-commerce.
Actually, the most important thing about Servera last year is that they actually grew in the stores as well, which is very, very impressive. So I think they had a very good effect overall on their brand as well. So it's very impressive. And right now we need to be able to cope with their future plans and their expansion plans and their growth. So that's why that's what we want to enable.
Mm. So what's the vision for this in for the AutoStore and the cooperation with Servera, but also for automation in further automation?
This is our first installation, and we will do more. And it's also Servera is our first customer into the installation. It's not the only one we want. We want to have a multi-client facility and also multi-client use of AutoStore, because that's where we see the best gain from our customers, where they can have a fraction of the investment instead of having the entire investment. So that's what we want to achieve in the future. So having multiple sites with automation, and which perhaps will be an AutoStore, I can't promise it to anyone, but it's highly likely that it will be, and that we have multiple customers in them.
I spoke to one of your colleagues in the business a while ago, and I asked him a similar question. I asked him, why do you choose to automate so much right now? And he said, well, basically, if we don't, the customers will do it themselves. So it's kind of a...
Historically, we have had it's been hard to find the right cases for automation, because the volumes in the Nordics are quite small. We're a small country. We don't have that many inhabitants, and the big e-commerce players in the Nordics aren't that big when it comes to when looking at it from a European level. But right now, with the COVID effects and the growth of e-commerce, we can see that right now it's the ones that have been a questionable investments are now a very suitable investment all of a sudden. So it's changing rapidly.
Thank you very much, Mikael Törnqvist, for speaking about logistics challenges and automation. Thank you.
You're welcome. It was interesting.